Oh, I'm gonna get Rick into my team, and Sally, and they're gonna work, and I'm gonna be in Jamaica and drinking rum chatas. Doesn't exist. It's not how it works. Anyway, here's what I did. Jumped into my dad's business. From 20 to 30 years old, I worked every day. I opened the store at 7 a.m. I went home at 10 p.m. I didn't hook up with girls. I didn't hang out with dudes. I put my head down and I put in real substantial work. The other thing I did was I was right about where the world was gonna go. I launched a website. That was right. Back when most people thought I should have opened a second liquor store. I started an email newsletter. How many people here have done an email newsletter or done email marketing in their career? Let me just see. Great, hold it up. Ready for this punchline? In 1998, I had 150,000 people on an email newsletter with 91% open rates. Don't clap, but thank you. It's not because I'm so great, it's because nobody else was doing email marketing and I bought that attention at a low cost because it wasn't a supply and demand issue. We didn't live in the world we live in now that every business spams the living crap out of you. How many people here had email in 1998, 1999? Do you remember how we rolled back then? We read every goddamn email and every word in every email, and that's why I did well. And so that killed for me. I sold a ton of wine. I was competing with people that were sending direct mail and catalogs and buying newspaper ads for the wine. And I was emailing them, getting in front of customers weeks and months before the other people, and it cost me nothing. And by the way, I was doing direct mail and print and radio as I started building up, and I saw the difference between buying attention at a discount or overpaying for attention because it's tried and true and it's what people always did. Next, Google AdWords came along. Google AdWords was super interesting to me. I saw Google, it was winning, it was better than Yahoo, and Ask Jeeves, and all the other crap that was out there back then. I'm like, I like Google, Google's good. How many people used Google in the early days, 2000, 2001? Remember good Google, when like, whatever you typed in, the first result was exactly what you were looking for? So that's why Google won for the youngsters in here, and then they created ads. And one thing I know more than anything, more than I know that the sun will come up tomorrow, I know that marketers ruin everything. It's what we do. I'm actively enjoying ruining Snapchat as we speak. It's what we do. Take attention, sell against it. But this was early Google. Nobody was ruining it yet. Nobody was doing SEM and things of that nature. And then they came out with an ad product. And I owned the word wine on Google AdWords for 5 cents a click. Before they even raised the minimum to 10 cents for 9 months before anybody bid me up. That's called day trading attention. I knew that people were on Google and would click the first result if it was an ad or not because it was new, and the liquor stores I was competing with didn't even know it existed. And so in a very quick period of time between a website, email marketing, Google AdWords, I was building a real business. And then my career took the substantial turn that got me to this stage tonight. YouTube came out. And I looked at it, and I was like, huh, this is gonna be big. And so in 2006, less than a year after YouTube had been out, with not one video on YouTube having 1 million views yet in the world, I started a video blog called Wine Library TV. The premise was, thank you, Mom. The premise was, I sat in my office, at my table with 4 bottles of wine, and I drank them. And it was 20 minutes long, something that Google and Yahoo flew me out to in 2007 to their companies because they couldn't understand people were watching it because back then everybody thought it had to be 5 seconds. And hundreds of thousands of people a day started watching that show 5 days a week for 5 years. And it was when I learned about content. Here's the big one for a lot of you, and I'm actually not gonna dig into it. I'm gonna let the smartest people in the room just understand it and leave it at that, because I'm just playing with myself. My YouTube show was the first time I didn't run advertising. It was the first time I did content. When I got the camera at Best Buy, when I sent somebody to go get it at Best Buy and come back, I thought I was gonna start the QVC of wine. That I was gonna sit there and I was gonna sell you wine. I was gonna say, buy this, go to the website, call this number, buy this. The camera goes on in the first episode, And if you ever dig it up on YouTube, you'll see I'm very tame, and because I'm thinking, and I realize, oh my God, this is gonna be on the internet forever. And I think this is gonna work. So what happens when this is big in a year or two and I'm at a party or a convention or in the store and somebody comes up to me with a glass of wine and says, hey, taste this. And what do you think? And I taste it and I say it's rubbish and they go, aha, I knew it. You told me to buy it on Wine Library TV. I got scared. I realized the transparency of it all really mattered. And so even if you watch the first episode, you could see my head spinning. And from that day, I realized from day one, episode one, I did 1,000 episodes of it, 5 days a week, 5 years, I realized I needed to be America's wine guy, not selling you wine. How many people here have a friend or relative that's fairly into wine? Raise your hands. Great. So you guys know what I know, which is the second that anybody gets even just a little bit of wine knowledge, they become a straight douchebag. And so the reason my show did well is I talked to people about wine, not down to them. My friends, you're gonna hear a lot of stuff over this week. Content marketing matters. What you do on Periscope and Facebook Live, on Snapchat and Facebook, on Instagram, on emerging things like Musical.ly and Twitter, and the 14 other things that will happen during your career, they're all gonna matter, right? If you pick the right ones early on and go hard, you can pop and you can really, really win. But if you don't have anything good to say, you will lose even if you're the first person there. It's like Christopher Columbus. The dude that ate the poison berry first, he died, right? Like, you've gotta pick the right thing. And so the punchline here is the following. The content that you're putting out, and I audited a lot of your coach's content, there wasn't a whole lot of coaching going on. There was a whole lot of selling going on. There was no social. You were pumping out content. People were asking you questions about the products in your Instagram posts, and you were nowhere to be seen because you just care about numbers. You care about width, not depth. My friends, it doesn't matter how many Instagram followers you have. It matters how many Instagram followers you have that care. YouTube changed my life. I went on the show, it did great, I did the show, it did great, and then YouTube sells for $1.7 billion to Google, and just so you know, back in 2008, $1.7 billion is like you hearing tomorrow that something was sold for $48 trillion. It was like, we couldn't believe it, it was the craziest number I'd ever heard, and that was the moment I said, my God, I was right about e-com, I was right about email, I was right about Google AdWords, I'm right about YouTube, this thing that I have, I can make a lot more money, maybe I don't need to build the biggest wine business in the world to buy the Jets. Maybe this gift of knowing what consumers are gonna do is a thing that I can do. And so instead, when I read the Google articles, I realized people angel invested in it. I'm like, what's angel investing? I Googled angel investing, I read what it was, and I said, the next time that I feel that feeling that drove me over the last 7 years for all the success that I had, that I was gonna invest. That happened 100 days later when I went to Austin, Texas, to South by Southwest, and everybody was talking about this new app that came out a week earlier called Twitter. Everybody thought it was the stupidest thing they ever heard of, because who cares if you're eating pizza or walking the dog? I thought that it was gonna be the next big thing. I met the founders, I invested, I made a video a week later that it was gonna be big. Facebook saw it, Mark Zuckerberg invited me to come out and speak with Dave Morin to Mark Zuckerberg and the team. I spoke, Zucks liked it, we had dinner, I bought stock from his parents, then I knew high school kids were on Tumblr, I invested in that, and the first three investments I ever made in my career were Twitter, Facebook, and Tumblr. I'm rich. Oh, there's some bad ones in there. I later invested in Yobongo and Gowalla, so. Anyway, nonetheless, that's good. That was mainly to brag too. And then I started VaynerMedia. I have an agency now, 650 person firm that works with Under Armour and Dove and Toyota and the biggest brands in the world, Johnson & Johnson, to do their social media marketing and their media buying. And that's basically been my life. That's what I care about. I know that everybody in here can win. I just think that most of you are not patient. I definitely know that most of you are just not working hard enough. I mean, just so black and white. And I think that most of you are not willing to lose. And that's a big one, that last one. Let me explain what I mean by that. You're sitting here right now still debating, is Snapchat a fad? How long will Snapchat be big? You're doing things that are on defense. You're scared to lose. I jump into those things. I don't care if they lose. I jumped into Social Cam. I jumped into Vine. I jumped into Plurk. I jumped into those platforms. Did all of them hit? Absolutely not. Did I learn things on producing content there? Yes, I did. Did Twitter and YouTube and Instagram and Snapchat hit for me? They sure did. The upside, let me promise you one thing. If you are right about one platform, if you decide tonight to go home and become the king or queen of Musical.ly for fitness, oh, you have a 14-year-old girl? Yeah. If you decide to win on that platform, if you decide to win on that platform, if you were to win and be the person that gets, you know, if you end up being the fat Jewish on Musical.ly, right? The person that wins the platform, like he did on Instagram, you could be wrong for the next 20 years of your life, but if you're right once, net-net, you've won. Net-net. And so, what I want to talk to you about is what's going on in the landscape, what I think could happen for you. The details of your success, they're all predicated on attention. Let me explain. So many people in here in January started crying because the Facebook algorithm changed. We got screwed. We got this. You got nothing. It was free. Do you call your local TV station and be like, look, I just shot a commercial. I'd like you to air it for free. No, you do not.
Yes.
You don't call the Wall Street Journal and be like, hey, Wall Street Journal, it's Sarah. I'm a coach. Got a full page ad for you. Can you put up for free? No, you do not. You're lucky it never existed for free in the first place. Number two, a lot of you that did Google know that what Facebook did is far less scary than what Google used to do. Some of you had the first result on diet or abs or whatever your business is, wine, natural, not with ads. Then Google changes the algorithm, you're on the 19th page and you went from making $15,000 a day to zero. The problem is people are crying and complaining instead of adjusting. Let me tell you what you should have done in January 2016.
Thanks.
You should have realized that Snapchat was coming and you should put it in the work. You should have realized with Facebook changing its algorithm, it created the greatest digital ad product in the last 20 years. No, you want to take your $6,000 that you make doing this right now and you just want to put it in your pocket. But if you took $1,000 of that $6,000, spent an hour and learned how to do Facebook ads and spent the $1,000, you'd be doing $20,000. But it's more fun to complain. Zuck screwed us. And so my friends, couple things. First and foremost, the number one day trading arbitrage available in the market right now is Facebook ads. If you have a dollar, go spend it on Facebook. A lot of people ask me, well, Gary, I don't know how to run Facebook ads. Okay. I know, I see a lot of you taking notes. I'll send you to a website to really figure this out. It's spelled out G. O-O-G-L-E. Oh, Gary, I didn't grow up with this social media stuff. I don't understand it. Hey, Rick, you didn't grow up driving. You figured it out. And so we live in an ecosystem where people complain and are confused and don't want to put in the work. Let me get this straight one more time. How many people here have run Facebook ads for their business? Raise your hand. How many have not? Raise your hand, it's okay. A lot. So you wanna run a business, you wanna be successful. You don't realize what's going on in society, you haven't lived outside in the real world, you haven't seen that the phone has become fundamentally the remote control of our lives. How many people here in every 24-hour window, including when you're sleeping, are always within arm's reach of their telephone? Raise it high and look around. Look at this. The phone, and I get it, you love judging, right? Maybe you grew up and you like judging, you're sad about technology. You don't like little Sally on the iPad all day. You love giving it to her when she acts up. Right? I know what you do, you go to a restaurant with your partner and you see a couple sitting there and they're both on the phone and you go, that's so sad, right? You love to judge another couple. You know what I see when I see that couple? I see the couple that I saw 20 years ago sitting at a restaurant, sitting across from each other, not saying a goddamn word to each other. I actually think when I see a couple both on the phone that it's nirvana and it's amazing. Because at least they're doing whatever the heck they want to be doing. Their relationship is broken, phone or not. My friends, let me tell you how I am going to buy the New York Jets and how a lot of you can become successful if you decide to follow what I'm talking about. I'm going to make all my money because you draw lines in the sand. You hear about things and you draw lines in the sand. You said 10 years ago that you don't need a cell phone, that this pager is good enough. Oh, there's some old dudes in here that did that. 8 years ago, a lot of you said, I'm not going on Facebook. I don't need a Facebook account. Watch this. How many people here by show of hands? How many people here by show of hands said at one point or thought at one point in their lives that they would never have a Snapchat account? Raise your hand. Of those people, please stand up right now. Don't be lazy. I mean, of the people that said they would never have a Snapchat account, stand up if you have one. Raise your hands. Stand up. Stay up for a minute. I want everybody to look around. Keep staying up. I see you up there. Look at this.
Yeah.
I'm going to make all my money on what you say you're not going to do that I know you're going to do. You can sit down, thank you. What just happened there and why I made you see it in that way is very, very important. Either you want it to be a certain way because of the way you grew up, either you wish it's a certain way because of the romantic way you look at the world. The biggest problem is you're not looking at it the way it actually is. I don't predict anything. In my little tech world, for the few that know me, everyone's like, you know, I go on a radio show, Gary, you're like Nostradamus, right? You predict the future. I don't predict the future. I haven't predicted anything. I just look at what people are actually doing right now. When I tell people Musical.ly is gonna be big, they're like, you're a genius. No, I wasn't. I went to the App Store, and I looked at the top 150 free apps, and I look at it every day, and Musical.ly's been in the top 40 for the last 7 months. I'm no genius. I put in the work. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so, we are living through, my friends, listen to me, we are living through the single biggest communication shift since the printing press. The way human beings interact with each other has changed. You sent the poop emoji in the last 24 hours. It's goddamn poop. Watch this one. You want to see how much everything's changed? Watch this show of hands. Remember, lying is the devil, so raise your hand. How many people here by show of hands now get upset? Get upset when another human being calls them?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Keep it up. I gotta look at this.
Totally.
This is insane. Did you just see that? Another human being calls them, they're upset. You know why? Because 50% of you, and it might have been even more, you realize, hey, why are you calling me and taking my time, text me, and I'll get back to you on my time. Mom! Now let me tell you why I made you do that. The number one asset in our society that has emerged, getting to the same level as the health and well-being of our families and money, is now time. Time is the number one asset. Let me tell you what marketing and advertising does. It steals people's time. You're putting something in front of somebody and they don't want it. They didn't go to Instagram to see your goddamn abs and sign them up. I'm super pumped that you squatted for the last 48 years in a row. And you're bubble butting it like nobody's business. But I have bad news for you. So has every other person on Instagram. And so supply and demand of attention and time trumps everything. Now, let me explain to you why Facebook ads matter so much and why you've got 18 to 24 months to take advantage of it. And by the way, I could care. Let me just say something about this because I think I'm listening to myself. I'm like, huh, I wonder what they're thinking. I would prefer that none of you do any Facebook ads because it's a marketplace. The more of you that do ads, the more expensive it gets. I've been selling a lot of things, books and wine, by getting to 1,000 people for 50 cents 4 years ago. Then it became $1, now it's $2. You start running, sign me up, this is how we do, it's gonna be even more expensive. It's just like Google. The word wine was 5 cents on Google, now it is $9. I'm not happy that people figured it out. I liked it at 5 cents. So please understand, every piece of advice that I'm giving you is predicated on one very important point. I know that 99% of you aren't gonna do anything about it. Yep, that is the level of disrespect I have for you. That you like to think it, that you're gonna do it, and I got good energy, so you're feeling it, you're gonna be super pumped, right? You're gonna go out, have a beer. He was amazing, super handsome, like amazing, right? We're gonna do this. He's right. You've been telling me we're gonna do Facebook, this and that, and then next Tuesday happens. That's what happens. I've been doing this a long time. I swear, the only reason I give the best advice in the world is because most people don't take it. And so I'm a great guy on both fronts. Facebook. It's great, but here's a problem. My business today, VaynerMedia, Toyota, Unilever, Procter, the biggest brand, not Procter, but GE, biggest brands in the world. What are they spending their money on? Television. By show of hands, how many of you now, when you watch television outside of sports, watch it on your time, not when it airs? Netflix, HBO Go, DVR, TiVo, raise your hand. Raise it high. Oh, weird, everybody. And how many of you fast forward every single commercial when given the chance? Yep. $90 billion spent making 30-second videos and distributing them in between TV shows, and nobody's watching. And if one of those brands that are my clients are lucky enough that, let's say, it does get in front of you because you drop your remote control off your bed. When that happens to you, and a commercial comes after you just watched basketball or your show, the second a commercial comes on, you grab your phone. Mm-hmm. And you tweet about what LeBron did, woo! You check your social, you check your numbers, you check your email, but I know one thing, you're not giving your attention to that Jeep going up that hill. So what do you think's gonna happen? I'm gonna help you, since I've lived in a couple of cycles. That money, over the next 2 to 3 years, will continue to be spent on TV because old school executives in their 50s want it to. And then they're gonna get fired because their businesses are gonna go down. And then 37-year-old Sally's gonna come and be the new CMO. And she's only lived like this. And she's gonna take all that TV money and she's gonna push it into this world. And you reaching somebody with your program or your squat or whatever the hell you're gonna put in front of them is gonna cost $19, not $3. And while you ponder if Facebook is going down or crying that they changed the algorithm on you or texting your friends, don't worry, they're gonna bring it back because we'll all leave. While you do that, the greatest ad product is living and breathing and treating. And then you're gonna wake up and realize you should go and it's gonna be too late. So my friends, let's break down the opportunities for you right now. Facebook ads, grossly underpriced. They're hard, you have to learn how to do it. Go to Google, go go to YouTube. If you learn by reading, I do not. Go to Google, read how to do it. If you learn visually or audio, go to YouTube, watch a video, type in, not complicated, how do I run Facebook ads? Watch it, learn, then go do it. And I will punch you in your mouth if you're sitting right now saying, oh, I'm gonna hire a 24-year-old. She'll know what to do. If it is your business, figure it out.
Yeah.
And you don't have an hour to watch a video, you jerk! Sorry. Number two, Instagram influencers. I know you are one too, you've got 9,000 fans, mazel tov, but all the other people, Charlene and others can tell you, you tell your story, and you should. And by the way, the only thing that matters in your story is your actual true story. There's a whole lot of 22-year-old life coaches running around here trying to tell everybody what to do. Love my 22-year-old business coaches that have never made a dollar in business except trying to sell people on giving business advice. Mm-hmm. Yeah, everybody got real quiet. Anyway, Instagram influencers. Instagram influencers. They want the money. There's a reason everybody with any kind of following on Instagram, when you go to their profile, has their Gmail account there. They want you to email them and offer them something. Offer them something that's authentic to them, but would benefit your business, negotiate prices, and see what it means to your business. You're not charismatic, you're not creative, you don't know what to do on social, good. When you're not good, and you don't have talent, and you don't have the time, you use money. It's one of the two things. Deploy dollars to Instagram influencers. There's a real business opportunity for a lot of people here on that. Number three, figure out Snapchat yesterday. Yesterday. I'll tell you why. Everybody's attention is gonna be there. Every 30, 40, and 50-year-old you know in 24 to 36 months will be on Snapchat. I said this in 2006, 7, and 8 on Facebook. People didn't believe me. Once again, going back to it, could care less if you do. Believe most of you won't, but if you figure out how to do it, here's why Snapchat's really interesting. Because of the nature of the platform, the thing that usually most intimidates you, which is, what do I put on it? Mm-hmm. For Snapchat, it's so reality TV, and it actually almost doesn't matter what you put on it. It's unbelievable. If just put your truth, walking into the gym, chasing my goddamn dog. Take a picture. Gum on the street. Brilliant. Reality TV works for a reason. We're just interested. It's rubbernecking. It's gossiping. It's hardwired in us. It can literally be anything, but just let it be your true thing. The reason I keep pounding the true thing, one of the things I found most fascinating when I was digging is people love to front. You love to front. You love to show it bigger than it actually is. You love to sell the lifestyle. This, that, the other. It's just not going to work. It's just not going to work. You can't hide. The internet exposes all the shadows of society. It is a bad blueprint. You might make it work for a few minutes, but you will be exposed and you will lose. Please keep that in mind. My friends, we're living through the most amazing time ever. Really, really. One of the things that I'm very passionate about is marketing. I'm fascinated by the presidential election, and not to go political, but it's amazing to me that data can show how great something is, yet if you just yell loud enough that everything is bad, people start believing it, right? And I'm not picking on him, I'm really not. This is a much bigger issue than that. I am stunned by that. And as humans in society that have social media, I'm gonna say one random thing and then I'll move on from this. The minority of angry people in America are very loud right now.
Yeah.
They will post every day, 400 times a day on every channel. And they are drowning out all of us in this arena because the majority of happy and ambitious and good people like us don't say anything about it. You go and take 40 flights a year, everything goes smooth, not a peep. Get a 4-hour delay, screw you, Delta. Our grandparents and great-grandparents lived through wars and depressions and real bad stuff. And you're crying about missing a couple of likes. Thanks, Grandma. My friends, the punchline's very simple. Patience is the number one reason people lose as entrepreneurs. They think for some reason, by raising their hand, I love when you're like, I'm doing it. I'm making the jump. Screw the man, I'm gonna do this. You convinced me, Cindy, I'm joining your team, I'm gonna do it. And then 5 days later, you're like, what happened? Why am I not winning? Because it's 5 days in, Harold, you jerk. Patience. Patience absolutely kills everybody. They want it now, you're just not patient. Because you're Americans, and you've had it so good, you've become soft. It's true. Yep. We're soft. We just are. Because we live in a generation now where we give people eighth place trophies. If my kids get an eighth place trophy, I'm gonna punch them in the face, my wife in the face, and the league in the face. Woo! Here I'm talking about positivity, and I just got a huge cheer for domestic violence. Here's why I just did that little rant, and it's gonna hurt you. We love to razz everybody else. That was fun, right? We love to make fun of people that give eighth place trophies. Do you know how funny it is to me how little people work when they want something so big? Do you know how much downtime and leisure there is here? Now, let me say something very clear. Work-life balance, your family, your interests matter. If you sit in this seat and you're pumped and you do not complain about your business, you win. I got nothing for you. But if you complain about your business and you wish you were bigger and you're wondering why other people are winning, you need to work more. Nobody leaves this conference going home and all of a sudden becomes smarter or more talented or more charismatic. Everybody can leave this conference and go home next week and work 9 extra hours a week.
Yep.
Everybody can.
Yep.
And do you know what happens when you work 9 extra hours a week? You can do the one thing that is foolproof. You want a system? Here's a system. Spend the next 1 year replying to every person that makes a comment on any social media post you send. All of them, one by one, all of them, 1 year. I'm gonna make you a big time promise, you're gonna make a lot more money. I live a life now with all the accolades that I've got going on where I get a message every day from somebody I went to high school and college with, and the opening line is, hey Gary, holy crap, were you on Conan O'Brien last night? You're so lucky, I just read, you're so successful, you're so lucky. My reply, hey Susan, you look great. Real quick, I'm not lucky. I'm like, remember when you went to the Jersey Shore every weekend after high school and drank and hooked up? Yeah, I worked. I'm not lucky. I worked.
Yeah.
Worked. Do you know how weird it is to be 22 to 30 and really not hook up? That's how insanely, actually, I don't recommend that much work. That was a mistake. But that's how much I worked. It's no luck. I'm not up here by accident. I didn't win the genetic lottery. I worked. I had talent, but I had self-awareness. I knew what I sucked at. Saturn, reading, algebra. I knew what I was great at, selling stuff. Knowing what people were gonna do before, and what I did since I was 12 years old, no different than Beyonce or LeBron or anybody else you look up to, your mom who's mothered the greatest way ever. No matter what, I went all in, pot committed. Instead of sitting up here and trying to figure out what I do, or read my books, or everybody else, go home, look yourself in the mirror, and start feeling comfortable with what you're good at. Figure Woo! Yourself out. You want to know who wins? You know who's winning here? The most self-aware. Self-awareness and self-esteem are the two drugs that drive success in our society. It is what matters. And what you need to do here is figure out a couple things. The world's changing. If you do not provide value, you will lose. You want to sell people into your program and your $130 product. They don't. So why don't you give them something up front? Why don't you give them so much up front that you guilt them into buying your stuff? Because that's what I do. That's my full plan. My plan's real simple. I'm just going to guilt you into buying all my books. There it is. And so, a couple things. You're more than welcome to continue to disrespect the reality of the market. You're more than welcome to say, I've been doing well without Snapchat and Facebook. I'm happy for you. Do you. But let's get to the punchline. How many people here are retiring in the next 10 years? And I don't mean, because I already see the hands, you're gonna crush it and retire. I mean, you're old and you're finished. Four. You're too young. Okay, Grandma, you're old. Respect, do you. But for the rest of you, I want you to understand. And by the way, you two ladies that are leaving, you better not be trying to beat the rush. You better be running back to your hotel to run Facebook ads. Everything that is happening in the world today that makes money didn't exist 10 years ago. It didn't exist. Not smartphones, not Facebook, YouTube, and Snapchat, Instagram, you know, maybe 11 years on a couple of those things, but it didn't exist. What do you think is gonna happen in the next 10 years? There are people running through your backyard trying to find virtual Pikachus right now. Do you understand? How can you underestimate what's going on? You're living it. You're living it every day. You're living in society every day. Your 50 and 60 year old friends, your grandpappy texted you last night. Things are happening and you're disregarding them in running your business because, I don't know, you're just not good enough. I don't know, you don't want it bad enough. I don't know what it is, but you've got to promise me, the quicker you understand it's 2017 and the world has completely changed, and the quicker you understand it's 2017 and nothing's changed. Hard work. Hard work. Hard work. There's nothing else. There's nothing else. There's nothing else. Here's a social media post. Why don't you post, what can I do for you? List your phone number, and then call everybody and speak to them for 15 minutes. Instead of deploying your mouth on social media 24/7, 365, why don't you deploy your ears? Why don't you do that? Why don't you pay attention to what's actually happening? And why don't you, instead of saying no, no Snapchat, no Musical.ly, no Facebook ads, why don't you say yes and figure it out? You got a lot of thoughts on Snapchat and Facebook marketing and all these other platforms when you've never done it. There's a whole lot of headline readers in this stadium tonight. You got thoughts, because some social media experts said a headline, and you don't know what the hell you're talking about. So, I challenge all of you this evening to understand in 2017, everything's changed except the hard work. Thank you.